Welcome to the Examsdaily YouTube channel. Today we can see the daily current affairs of November 30, 2019.
இதுவரை நம்ம யூடியூப் சேனலை சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணாதவங்க சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பட்டனை கிளிக் பண்ணுங்கள். கூடவே மறக்காமல் பெல் பட்டனையும் கிளிக் பண்ணுங்கள். அப்போ தான் நாங்கள் போடுற ஒவ்வொரு வீடியோவும் உங்களுக்கு உடனுக்குடன் வரும்.
ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வி கேன் சீ த ஸ்டடி குவிஸ் ஆன்சர்ஸ். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் இன்டர்நேஷனல் டே ஆஃப் த கேர்ள் சைல்ட் இஸ் அப்சர்வ் ஆன் விச் டேட். த ஆன்சர் இஸ் அக்டோபர் 11. செகண்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் ஃபிஃப்த் நேஷனல் கவுன்சில் ஆன் இந்தியாஸ் நியூட்ரிஷன் சேலஞ்சஸ் வாஸ் ஹெல்ட் இன் விச் சிட்டி. த ஆன்சர் இஸ் நியூ டெல்லி. Third question is, in which city people will get free food in exchange for 1 kg plastic? The answer is Ambigapur. Fourth question is, who has been awarded Nobel Prize in Literature for the year 2019? Answer is Peter Handke. Fifth question is, first National Hindi Science Writers Conference was held in which state? The answer is Uttar Pradesh. November 30, Computer Security Day. Computer Security Day began in 1988, around the time that computers were becoming commonplace, even if they were yet to become ubiquitous in homes. The 1980s saw not only increased usage of computers, especially in business and government, and the internet was in its early stages. These days, electronic devices such as smartphones, tablets and computers make up an important component of our everyday lives. While communication has become easier and more efficient than ever before, these technical advancements have brought with them new concerns about privacy and security. There's even a holiday dedicated to keeping your online data safe and secure. It's fittingly called Computer Security Day. Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates discussed to develop mega crude refinery in Maharashtra. Saudi Arabia and the United Arab Emirates have discussed to develop the planned mega crude refinery in Maharashtra at an initial cost of $70 billion. It will have a capacity of 1.2 million barrels per day, integrated with a modern petrochemical complex. Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi and Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE Armed Forces, and Mohammed bin Salman bin Abdul Aziz, Saudi Arabia's Crown Prince, Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Defense, jointly presided over the second meeting of Saudi Emirati Coordination Council in Abu Dhabi. The two oil-rich nations discussed ways and means to secure the supply of at least 6 lakh barrels per day of Saudi and Emirati crude oil for Indian market. So we can expect the question from here is, Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates discussed to develop mega crude refinery in which state? The answer is Maharashtra. Golden Jubilee edition of IFFI culminates in Goa. The Golden Jubilee edition of International Film Festival of India culminated in Goa. The festival saw screening of 300 films of various languages from India and abroad for delegates from different parts of the world. The IAFI was awarded the ICFT UNESCO Fellini Medal at the closing ceremony, which was received by Information and Broadcasting Secretary Amit Khare and Director of Festival Chaitanya Prasad. Governor of Goa Satyapal Malik, Chief Minister of Goa Dr. Pramod Sawant, Union Minister Babul Supriyo and others were present on the occasion. So we can expect the question from here is, how many number of films screened in IFFI 2019? Dr. Harshvardhan calls for technology and innovation to be the backbone of development. The 8th Foundation Day of Global Innovation and Technology Alliance and Confederation of India Industry was addressed by the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, Dr. Harshvardhan. The minister recognized and felicitated the exceptional performance of GITA project in contributing towards enhancing the country's innovation ecosystem. The theme of the event was Making India Future Ready. So we can expect the question from here is, which minister was addressed the 8th Foundation Day of Global Innovation and Technology Alliance? The answer is Dr. Harshvardhan. Asian Development Bank and India signed $451 million loan to strengthen power connectivity in Tamil Nadu. The Asian Development Bank and the Government of India signed the $451 million loan to strengthen power connectivity between the southern and northern parts of the Chennai to Kanyakumari Industrial Corridor, which is the part of the East Coast Economic Corridor in Tamil Nadu. ADB is the lead partner of the Government of India for developing ECEC. The signatories to the loan agreement were Mr. Samit Kumar Kare, Additional Secretary, Department of Economic Affairs in India's Ministry of Finance, and Mr. Kenichi Yokoyo Ma, Country Director of ADB's India Resident Mission. So we can expect the question is, India and which organization signed the loan agreement to strengthen power connectivity in Tamil Nadu? The answer is Asian Development Bank. Kishan Reddy inaugurates first international conference on landslides, risk detection and resilience. Minister of State for Home Affairs G. Kishan Reddy inaugurated the first international conference on landslide risk reduction and resilience in New Delhi. While addressing the conference, Mr. Reddy called for developing technology to anticipate disasters like landslides and develop infrastructure to quickly respond to minimize the damage. The minister said that landslides have attracted global attention as they may cause huge havoc on communities, livestock, environment, leading to huge loss of lives. He expressed hope that deliberations in this conference will go a long way in finding long-term solutions to natural disasters. So we can expect the question from here is, where the first international conference on landslides, risk reduction and resilience held? The answer is New Delhi. Home Minister Amit Shah to address valedictory session of 47th All India Police Science Congress. Home Minister Amit Shah will be reaching Lucknow to address the valedictory session of 47th All India Police Science Congress. The two-day event was inaugurated by Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry and retired IPS officer Kiran Bedi. Police officers from SP to DG rank from various states and union territories are participating in the annual event. Uttar Pradesh Police, in association with the Home Ministry and Bureau of Police Research and Development, is organizing the event. So we can expect the question from here is, where was 47th All India Police Science Congress held? And the answer is Lucknow. Dr. Jitendra Singh to inaugurate two-day conference on Jal Shakti and Disaster Management. A two-day conference is to be held on November 30 to December 1, 2019 at Jammu. Sayog Sangal resolution to be adopted in the valedictory session. The Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances in collaboration with governments of Tamil Nadu and Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir is organizing a two-day conference on Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat with focus on Jal Shakti and Disaster Management. So we can expect the question from here is, where a two-day conference on Jal Shakti and Disaster Management is going to help? The answer is Jammu and Kashmir. Passing out parade to be held at Indian Naval Academy on 13th November 2019. Indian Naval Academy, Elimala, will hold its passing out parade for Autumn Term 2019 on Saturday, that is 13th November 2019. Trainees comprising midshipmen and cadets of 97th Indian Naval Academy course BTEC, 97th Indian Naval Academy course MSc, 28th Naval Orientation course Extended, 29th Naval Orientation Course Regular and 29th Naval Orientation Course Coast Guard will pass out as officers on successful completion of their training. Six trainees of various friendly foreign nations will also pass out this term. So we can expect the question from here is, when will India Naval Academy hold its passing out parade for Autumn Term 2019? The answer is 13th November 2019. Deepika wins gold, Angita bags silver in Asian Archery Championships. Indian archers Deepika Kumari won gold while Angita bagged silver medal in the women's individual recurve event of the 21st Asian Championships in Bangkok. Deepika defeated Angita 6-2-0 in the one-sided final. The duo had earlier secured an individual Olympic quota for the country by storming into semi-finals of the event. So we can expect the question from here is, who won gold in 21st Asian Archery Championships? The answer is Deepika Kumari. Sports Ministry has constituted a 13-member expert committee to review the draft National Sports Code. The expert committee will be headed by former Supreme Court Judge Justice Mukundam Sharma, former sportsperson Gagan Narang, Baichung Bhutia, Anju Bobby George, and National Badminton coach Pulela Govichand are part of the panel. Boxing President Ajay Singh, Coco Federation President Sudhanshu Mittal, Athletic Federation President Adila Sumariwala, and Weightlifting Federation President Baishya have been included in the committee. So we can expect the question from here is, how many members expert committee in Sports Ministry to review the draft National Sports Code? The answer is 13. Now we can see the today quiz questions. First question is, International Day for Disaster Risk Reduction is observed on which date? Second question is, where was 10th National Cultural Festival held? Third question is, Jammu and Kashmir to start telemedicine service in which city? Fourth question is, 7-day mega multimedia exhibition was held in which city? Fifth question is, which country pledges $56 billion in aid to Nepal?
நீங்க பார்த்தா இந்த வீடியோக்கு கீழே இருக்க டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் பாக்ஸில் தினசரி வார மாத நடப்பு நிகழ்களோட PDF-ம் அதோட வீடியோஸ் லிங்க்கும் கொடுத்துருக்கோம். அது மட்டும் இல்லாமல் குவிஸுக்குரிய லிங்க்கும் கொடுத்துருக்கோம். இதை நீங்கள் பயன்படுத்திக்கோங்க. தேர்வில் வெற்றி பெறுங்க. நன்றி.